Hello friends, welcome back to S20 Study. Today, that is on 25th of July 2019, South Indian Bank has conducted its exam for PO. So now let's see what is the exam analysis as well as the paper analysis of South Indian Bank PO 2019 exam. First, let's see what are the pattern, like what is the exam pattern and all the discussion. Later, let's see what are the important topics from which the questions have been appeared today. So, coming to the exam pattern, there are four different sections and there is sectional timing for each and every section, okay, separate sectional timing. So, now let's see what are the sections in the exam. First of all, there is reasoning and aptitude section, and there will be 40 questions from reasoning and aptitude. So this is section 1, and the marks for 40 questions will be 50. Okay, there will be 40 questions and 50 marks, and there will be 40 minutes of time allotted to you in order to solve this reasoning and aptitude section separately. So this is the separate sectional timing, 40 minutes just for reasoning and aptitude. After that, the second section is general and banking awareness. The questions will also be asked according to economics, like the questions will be even related to the general awareness, banking awareness, as well as the economics and the economy. So coming to this particular section, there are 40 questions asked and there are 50 minutes of time, like 50 marks given, and the timing is only 20 minutes. I'm repeating this point. For banking awareness and general awareness section, there are 40 questions, 50 marks, as well as only 20 minutes. Okay, maximum time given for this particular section is just 20 minutes. Okay, so next there is English section, or separate English section. So in that there are 40 questions, 50 marks and 40 minutes. So the last section in the exam paper is data analysis as well as interpretation. The questions will be asked from this. Coming to number of questions, there are 40 number of questions and 50 marks. So and the time is 40 minutes. So in total, coming to the complete paper, there are 160 questions, 200 minutes, and in time will be 140 minutes. So coming to these four sections, you need to manage time for banking awareness because you have 40 questions and just 20 minutes. So at max within 30 seconds, you have to solve the questions. So this is the exam pattern which have appeared today. So the students told that the paper was moderate. Few students told that the paper was difficult. So the paper is analyzed to be moderate itself. So coming to the tips which I would like to give you is manage time coming to the banking awareness because you have 40 questions and 20 minutes. And coming to the difficult section in the entire paper, students told that the candidates who have appeared for this exam told that this particular banking awareness is the most difficult section in today's exam. So now let's see what are the topics where you need to concentrate mostly. Okay, so first of all, coming to the English language, the questions have been asked from close test, spotting errors, antonyms, synonyms and comprehension. So comprehension is very important because most of the candidates runs out of time by wasting most of the time in comprehension. Please don't waste most of the time for comprehension. Allot the time equally. And coming to the reading comprehension, first read the question and then read the paragraph so that you can save a lot of time because you'll have the knowledge about the question. So, and the second tip coming to the English is please concentrate on the basics such as your grammar, vocabulary and all. It helps you to solve most of the questions. So spotting errors as usual is very important. So please also concentrate on antonyms and synonyms. Antonyms are nothing but opposites. Synonyms means meanings of the words. So please concentrate on the antonyms and synonyms. The more you practice, the more you can answer them. And if you are unable to get the answer for antonyms and synonyms, read the question twice or thrice. So you may have the idea, you may get the idea about the answer then. So these are the topics which you need to concentrate coming to English section. So next, coming to the aptitude and reasoning. First let's see reasoning. Please manage your time coming to reasoning, because most of the students told that the time is insufficient while solving the reasoning section questions. So please concentrate on time management coming to banking, the general awareness as well as the reasoning. So these two are like, you know, having a few logical questions, so you need more time. So time management is very important. So coming to the reasoning, what are the topics which you need to concentrate more, and what are the topics which are covered in today's exam? Are they've asked questions from puzzles, blood relations. For blood relations, every time I'm giving a simple tip which will help you to save a lot of time. Coming to the blood relations, start reading the question from last to first, okay? Start reading the question from last to first, and start relating the question to you, and try to solve it within less than a minute, okay? It's really helpful and useful, and mostly the questions from puzzles and blood relations are compulsory questions. Coming to blood relations, they will always ask the moderate questions. Never they are going to ask you very high level and difficult questions. So you can easily score marks coming to blood relations, and then concentrate on coding and decoding as usual. And then they have also asked questions from series. So normally coming to series, they may ask you numeric questions, alphanumeric questions or alphabetic questions, or they may ask you questions such as they'll give you series and they'll ask you to find out the missing number in the series, or they may ask you to tell what number may appear in the next of the series or in the place of question mark. So these kind of questions will be asked mostly coming to the series questions. So these are the most important topics coming to reasoning. So coming to the computer aptitude, the questions have been asked from the very basic things, such as easy basic questions, moderate questions, but few questions were logical and indirect. Students told that they are unable to solve 2 to 3 questions coming to this computer aptitude section. Coming to the computer aptitude, the questions have been asked from key, like, you know, keyboard shortcuts and basic questions such as emails, input output devices and all. And make sure you are strong with the computer basics and computer fundamentals, okay? And Microsoft Office questions are always important. So coming to the data analysis and interpretation section, please concentrate on 3 different questions. First is bar graph, and then line graph, and then pie chart. Only from these 3 they're going to ask you questions. Once you are thorough with this section, you can easily score and easily crack the cutoff. So please concentrate, and this is one of the easiest section where you can score maximum number of marks, because it is, the questions are direct and the basic questions. So this is one of the easiest section, I can tell. And please also concentrate on the table questions. Like, they can also ask you by giving the tabular format. They'll give you the data in the form of tabular format and question, or pie chart under question, or bar graph. Only these 3 questions, type of questions, will be asked in the exam. And coming to the general awareness, first please concentrate on history, politics. Questions are asked from the places, like this place, that place, naming the places and all. So those questions were being asked in today's exam. And capitals, as usual, what is the capital of so and so place, like that. The basic questions related to places, books and others, history and geography. Okay, they may also ask regarding the authors of the books, which are very basic. So, and in order to have a good score in your general awareness, students, I've already suggested them to read newspapers daily at least for 1 hour, and also to follow the current affairs from 2019 to present, like 2019 January to present, because last 6 months current affairs is very essential to crack this general awareness section. So coming to the banking awareness, the basic questions were asked related to the banks and schemes related to the particular banks, and also what are the different roles and responsibilities related to RBI. And most of the questions were asked about the schemes, rules, and laws of banks. So concentrate on those topics. So that's it. I've told you all the important topics which have been appeared in today's exam. The paper was moderate. Cutoff is dependent upon the difficulty level of the paper. So the cutoff is not officially announced yet. So the cutoff increases, it goes high if the paper is very difficult, if the difficulty level of the paper is very high, else they'll reduce the cutoff. So you need not worry at all. So there are three stages for the selection process. First stage of South Indian Bank PO exam is already done today. So the students who have selected or who have crossed the cutoff of this particular exam will be having the group discussion as your second round, and then you'll be having the final interview. So hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'm going to make more and more videos regarding when are they going to announce the results, what is the official cutoff and all. And also I'm going to make a video regarding the answer key of today's exam. So what you need to do is you have to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos. And if you subscribe and hit the bell icon whenever I make a video, you will be notified. So all the very best for the students who have attempted this exam and who are also going to attempt the group discussion and the interview in the coming future. And I hope you found this video useful. Also, don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching, and all the very best.